Welcome back to another Den Den Boys video. We're back.
Back in the flesh.
We're back in the flesh. It's been way too long, but we're finally back together playing some games. My name's Garth.
I'm Vaughn.
And together we are the Den Den Boys. So, what are we doing today? Well, today's video, as nominated by @2happygamers, our top 10 games of all time. Okay, the greatest games of all time. Now we thought, okay, we've done, people do those videos quite often. How are we going to put our own spin on it? This is our top 10 games of all time from the last 20 years of gaming together. We're up to our 20th anniversary of playing games together. These are our top 10 greatest co-op memories ever.
Of the last 20 years.
20 years.
Yeah.
The last two is going to be our greatest gaming achievement of all time and where it all started. So, before we get into the actual top 10, here's our honourable mention. These are the games that we're like, man, just couldn't quite squeeze it in, but they're very, very worthy of being in the top 10 on another day. My honourable mention is Penguin Land for the Master System. A great puzzle platformer game on its own, so that's already why it's in. The memories attached to it were obviously playing through 50 levels together on one copy. And then finding my own copy of the game later on and the battery backup having been saved to level 41. And we just thought, why don't we just finish the game off for the person? So they're my two memories of playing that. And obviously we played it on a lot of other systems like the Mega City and stuff like that. But just pure co-op, 50 levels playing together. That's my honorable mention. Penguin Land for the Master System. What's your honorable mention?
Okay, my honorable mention is Groove Jigoku Volume 5. So this is a Japanese PS1 import, Japan exclusive, picked it up in the last 5 years or so. It's a great game to play at parties. It's a great sort of co-op game. It's made up of sort of mini games, incredibly quirky. I think you've sort of been sent to hell and you're sort of doing these mundane tasks to sort of spend your time. A particular note, one of the greatest sort of mini games of all time is the wood chopping mini game, which sees you chopping wood, but avoiding the bunnies and trying to make it to
real animals in half.
And there's like a woman, an old lady, sort of praying next to you or something. It's totally bizarre, but
so it's addictive. It's just one more go,
And there's a really good music editor on there too. You can have a play around with it and actually sort of loop music, sort of create music.
In terms of our memories with it, it's always been like, the 100 chop, and it's always like, just, you take it to a party, you say, here, play this, and they go, what the hell is this? And then they can't put it down.
Yeah.
And the 100 club is an exclusive club.
It is.
The PSP is the, we're going to go to the 200 club one day. alright, so this is now officially the top 10. So these are our greatest co-op memories of all time in the last 20 years. So, I'm going to start with the Red Star for PS2. An amazing Ikaruga / Streets of Rage side-scrolling beat-em-up sort of game. So that's why it's in there, because it's amazing on that front. But the memories attached to this were our favourite gaming magazine, which was Games TM, had this as a front cover. And we were like stoking on the idea of the preview of this game coming out. And then it all of a sudden just disappeared into like development hell. We don't know where it went. Went straight to DVD, basically. And we were on our game hunting, as we usually do, and in this bargain basement, a bargain bin, out the front of this nothing sort of pawnbroker / game store, were all these copies brand new sealed of the Red Star. I was like, wasn't that a gamey? So that was one memory of like, this one, why it's in the top 10. The other memory was obviously playing the hell out of it, playing tons of it, getting to the last boss, and basically finding out that the last boss was semi-broken. It was bullet hell, and you could not
cramp.
People were like, oh, beat the Red Star. Bullshit. It was that hard, it was broken, right? Mm. So, for the first time in my life, I bought an action replay, punched in the codes, and got us invincibility so we could see the last boss. Because we had put tons of it. I mean, it's not like we didn't bash our heads against people. Mm. And we beat it. And now, from that point on, it's been in our greatest game of all time from that moment. So, the Red Star, number 10.
Okay, the first game I have here is Plock. For the Super Nintendo. This is a USA NTSC copy. So Plock is one of our favourite sort of gaming memories, in that it's a platformer, 2D platformer, single player, but we've turned it into a co-op experience by alternating, having sort of our strengths on certain stages. Incredibly colourful, incredible stage design, one of the greatest video game soundtracks of all time.
Clocked it 15 years ago.
15 years ago we first beat it, and that we've been playing it for 5 years on and off at that point. There's no passwords, no battery backup.
A little bit further incrementally every time.
And then we sort of beat it and we talk about it and for the years that followed. And then last night we actually tried to sort of do our first playthrough in 15 years. And got within sort of the last sort of 99% couple of levels. Plock, absolutely in the Dan Enboy's top 10 great memories.
Easily. Greatest platformer of all time, in my opinion. The next one, Mario Party for the GameCube. It's just a great co-op game, and we have these great memories of... This is my favourite in the series. I think it's the best in the series.
Number four.
Yeah, I think this is the best in the series, and the reason why it's in our top 10 is because we just have so many memories of playing with different people who aren't necessarily gamers, but you can play with anyone. Yeah. And 50 round minimum.
50 rounds.
It had to be 50 round seshes. 50 round seshes. And we'd sometimes start at like 2 o'clock in the morning, and I'd be catching the train at like 4 o'clock in the morning, and we would just pound out 50 rounders like they were just nothing. Some epic sessions, and obviously setting the high scores on some of the games like Domination and the ice skating and stuff like that. I love that game. It's a great multiplayer game.
Yeah, so it has the Mario Party in it.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so next I have another Japanese import, a bit of a theme here, for the PS1, and that is Ori no Ryuri, which is a cooking game for Sony's PlayStation, which was a bit of a showcase for the dual analogs, because a lot of the mini games are built around using the analogs. In particular, the greatest the beer related sort of experience in video gaming, and that's the beer tapping.
I can see myself doing it now. Down.
Yeah, tilting that glass, leveling it up, not too much head, and getting scored out of 100 per beer.
Time limit.
It's crazy. It's a lot of memories of playing the game, playing the beer tapping, playing all the other multiplayer. If you don't have it, you should get it. It's one of our all-time favorites.
And taking it to like 24-hour game session with charity, and just saying, you know, the mood's getting down, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, let's play some beer tapping in Houston. It just lifts the mood. One more go. It's such a great game. Fact, it actually was our first video on the YouTube channel.
Check it out.
It was tapping beers. Alright, so next one. All-time classic, Pocky and Rocky for the Super Nintendo. This is in the top 10. A, because it's an amazing side-scrolling shoot-em-up co-op experience, so two-player at its finest. It's tough, and so we tend to have a liking for the games that are more tough, you know, and we earned the clockage. And same sort of thing, we played this game, we loved it, we got a certain way into it, and then started beating our head against a brick wall, going, we can actually beat this. But through practice and getting better at it in two-player, we managed to clock it together, and it was one of the greatest clocks of all time. So, Pocky and Rocky goes in, 100%. Top 10.
Okay, my next game I've got here is Neo Turf Masters. This is the Neo Geo Pocket version. We tend to play the arcade MVS cartridge. If you don't know what our favourite sort of style of game is, it's often golf.
We've got about a top 10 out of golf games.
We have to sort of limit ourselves to one golf game. But in particular, the strongest memory with this game is it's our sort of it's been our warm up game for the last sort of 10-15 years or more. It's just a game that when we start off a sesh, we sort of chuck it on. Chill out, play 18 holes. It usually turns into sort of 4 hours.
Nice warm up.
Some beers on the side, and shout out to Vinyl Blaster in Canada, who runs the international Neo Turf Masters competition. We submit scores twice a year. That's happening at the moment. So Neo Turf Masters.
I love this game. Just obviously, it's a great golf game, but just the idea of driving 3 hours to your house, coming down. And we knew it was always going to be just a warm-up game, chill out in the game, drink, crack a first beer, and just play a couple of rounds of golf. Set the tone, it's just memories.
It doesn't get better.
Yeah, it doesn't get better. This one, Sega Get Bass Fishing for the Dreamcast. two memories are attached to this one. One was just the sheer amount of time we put into it and trying to unlock all the lures. And the way we turned this one-player experience, the competition mode, into a two-player game, where one person would be throwing the rod in, catching a big bass, hooking in, the other person would be cheering them on, and bang, giving the control to the next person, smash it, get a bass in, you know, strategizing, where we're going to go, all sorts of stuff, and winning all the tournaments. That, the amount of hours we played was amazing, and I remember one time you going to bed going, I've had enough of this game, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, and then you woke up the next morning and I'm still playing the bass, like trying to get that the Sonic lure. And then the other memory was where we found it, was walking into our local pawnbroker, cash position, and just seeing this mint condition so you could get bass. 20 bucks, and was just like, that's unheard of in Australia, you know, Japanese rules game. So they're my two memories, and that's why it's in the top 10. Easy.
Very cool. And then I have here Ribbit King for the PlayStation 2 and GameCube. We tended to play the GameCube edition. This is the PS2 game. There's not much difference between them, of course. So Ribbit King is what they call Frolf, which is a cross between frogs and golf, or golf with frogs, but with a twist. You catapult the frogs, you have a mallet, hammer, and sort of hit the catapult to sort of send the frog flying. And instead of doing the least amount of strokes, you're actually sometimes trying to do the most amount of strokes within a couple of
eight or so.
But you're racking up a high score by setting off chain reactions where the frog links up, sort of multiplies, it flies, swims through the lake.
And if you can chain them together, that's when your multipliers go through the roof.
Big scores. And
when it happens,
and the memories, it was a game that we would put on at some point during the set.
The story mode.
And introducing other people to Ribbit King. There's nothing else quite like it. So Ribbit King gets our vote.
Alright, so top 10, we're down to the last 22. So I said at the beginning of the video, this was going to be, the last two were going to be the greatest gaming achievement we've done together and where it all started. So, number 2, this is our greatest gaming achievement. Super Monkey Ball for the GameCube. Now, why it's our greatest gaming achievement is because we unlocked Master Mode together. We turned a one-player game into a two-player experience. So, go all the way back to the start. We're in Blockbuster Video. Remember when Blockbuster Video existed? We got the GameCube. We're like, what are we going to play? So we hire this, there's all the sports games and nothing really jumped off the page. Vaughn was like, why don't we get that to go? That looks interesting. Sure, let's play that. As soon as it went in the machine, it was like a hit of crack. We're like, this is where it's at. Where has this been all my whole life, right?
So addictive.
Then it started getting to the point where we're getting better at it. You've beaten level 7, you coached me through level 7, you know, like, you'll beat it eventually. We finally got there. Then we started blocking the game. And then we found out there was Master Mode. And we thought, well, that's just insane. Who's going to do that? And the Master Mode is basically beat the 50 stages, beat the 10 bonus stages without a continue.
Yeah, you can't. You know, start with 2 lives or something.
Devilish stages, right?
Yeah. No continue.
That's too hard. Then I got to playing the game and worked out some strategies for getting a few extra lives and thought, what if we pooled our skills together? We could do this, right? So it was like, what stages are you good at? Vaughn sat down and worked out, okay, these are the ones that I could do with my eyes closed. I'm very, very confident. These are the stages I were good at. We came together in my shitty little house at Moochow Street.
Yes.
We had 2 CRTs set up. We had one with the real game on it and one we were using for practice, just to get our eye in. And so when it got to a stage, like, I'm just going to have a practice, get our eye in, pause the other one, great, ready to go, confident, go for it, right? We get through all the 50 stages. Numerous times, failed on the bonus stages. The time that it happened, we get to the last bonus stage, and there was some hairy ones where I pulled off some good moments, you pulled off some good moments. You get to the last stage, which was your one, last bonus stage to get to Master Mode. 2 chances, couple of blown chances. Your last go, coming to the section, you had to bounce on these 3 island lily pads that were at speed, time it right with the trajectory to hit the goal. And you pulled it off.
Yeah.
On the last, last attempt at like 4 o'clock in the morning, we've been playing for 20 hours.
Yeah.
Non-stop, just grinding to the wall, and you did it. And I remember just losing my marbles. It was the greatest experience we've ever had. We even got a plaque made up for it.
Yeah.
So that's one side of it. And then the other side was the amount, just the fun we had playing Monkey Target. Yeah. Like the Monkey Target minigame is, they could have released a whole game on Monkey Target. It's perfect.
Yeah.
So our greatest gaming achievement, Super Monkey Ball. Number 2. What's number 1?
Number 1, drum roll please.
Where's my malt label?
So it is Toe Jam and Earl for the Sega Mega Drive. Released in 1991. This is the game that if it wasn't for this, there wouldn't be a Dan Dan Boys and we wouldn't be sitting here now talking to you.
It's where bromance was born.
This was the first game that we beat together. I'd had it as a kid. I had sort of sold it. Found a copy at Cash Converters 10 years later, but I didn't have the right person to play it with at the time because it requires a special dedicated individual.
It's not short. It's probably two and a half to three hour game if you play it, if you get everything.
If you take your time and you can still fail deep in the game. So not many people are up for that, it turns out. But when I met Garth, it wasn't long until we put this on and played it all night together.
And
beat the game.
And even glitched. I think that kind of set us in stone because it glitched on our first playthrough. Yeah. And it missed a shit piece. And like, normally, you know, people would be like, "Oh well, too bad." We were like, "Nah, bro, let's start it all over again." So we played two rounds of it, and it was like that's where the gaming journey began. It was like, if you're willing to play that all over again, we're in the same mindset. We're gonna be good.
And so we would continue to play it like every year. We'd beat it at least once or twice. You know, 20 years later, we did it yesterday. You know, our dream is to beat it in less than 60 minutes, which is a speed run. And we're not too far off that milestone.
We'll
Toe Jam and Earl for life.
There you go, dude. What a list. Yes. That was rad. There's some great memories in that list.
I mean, it was hard to cull.
There's 30 games we thought of, but this was
the cream of the crop. And it could change on other days.
There could be someone to get in here in the future. In the next 20 years. So if we have 20 years more of gaming, we could put
the 40-year
different games and we'll be like, no, that's out. This one's in. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I had fun rapping about some of these games. So hope you enjoyed it. Hope you give us a like, a share, a comment, do all that great YouTube stuff. If you've played the games and you love them yourself, we'd love to hear about it. And also stay tuned for our next video, which is going to be our Hall of Fame entry, And we'll hopefully see you very soon for another Dan Dan Boys video.
Stay tuned.
Peace.